Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how to unwrap multiple different objects into one singular UV map. This is useful if you wanted to, for example, bake a texture onto a few different objects, but have that all contained within one texture map, which would help you save resources in a game, for example. This might not be what everyone wants to do, but it's an important skill to know nonetheless, because sometimes it is important to know. So to do this, all we need to do is, first of all, go into edit mode with all these objects. To do that, we just have to have them all selected. So since there's only three objects in my scene, I could just press A to select all, and that's going to select all my objects. But if you had more objects in your scene, or you're not sure, then I recommend just left-clicking your cylinder, and then shift-left-clicking your cube and cuboid. Also, if you want to follow along with this, by the way, I have a link to a file in the description, which will have these objects which have already been marked with seams, so you can just easily follow along and get this practice in. Then, now I've got them all selected, I'll just press Tab to go into edit mode. You can see I'm now in edit mode with all of them selected. You can see I've got my seams marked already, so if I press A here, you can see all of our UV maps are applied over each other. So to have all of these separated out across the UV map for baking or texture painting, all we would need to do is press U with everything selected, so I've just pressed A, and then U, and then choose Unwrap. And you can see it's now unwrapped everything together. However, we have a bit of a problem, and that's, for example, our cube here is really small, which doesn't make much sense, and that's going to create some issues if you want everything to be averaged out at the same scale, as it should be, because we've actually applied the scale of all these objects. The first workaround would be to join all of these objects together in object mode, and then unwrap it, and that will unwrap everything at the same scale, because they're the same object. However, that's not really ideal, because maybe we want to keep those objects separate. Instead, what we can do is come to our UV editor here and press A to select everything. Then we can come to our UV, and where it says average island scale, we can just left click that, and you can see now we have everything at the scale, which makes sense. However, everything's overlapping now, which is a bit of an issue. To fix that though, is also very simple. All we need to do is, still with everything selected, I'll press UV, and there's an option here called Pack Islands. I'm just going to left click that, and here you've got a few options. Most important thing is you want to keep the margin method at scaled, and the margin I'm going to set to 0.01, and press Pack. A little progress bar will appear, and when it's done, it should look like this. You can see we've got all of our unwraps at the average scale. Our UV islands are also separated with a bit of a gap, which will allow us to prevent any overlap. And you can see it's also been packed closely together, which is good for optimizing texture space. And yeah, that just about covers it. A simple but very useful tip to know for UV unwrapping multiple objects. If you want to learn about more UV unwrapping tips like these, make sure to check out my free playlist for beginners on UV unwrapping in Blender. I've got plenty for tutorials on important UV unwrapping concepts and tips like these. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.